Tonight, we're taking action for you with a life-saving story on preventing diabetes. 79 million Americans have pre-diabetes, and they don't even know it.
And that's because there are things that you could do to prevent it, or at least getting off of it. Now, Channel 4 Action News anchor Michelle Wright joins us with a look at how far current treatments have come, the cost to all of us, and the diet and exercise you definitely need to prevent it.
Yeah, Mike, we want to get that message out. Many of you watching right now have pre-diabetes, even if you're not showing symptoms at all, and there are things you can do to prevent getting it. But treatment, we should say, has come so far and is giving patients a whole lot of freedom these days. So let's start by taking a look at one woman's experience.
Terri Seidman is one of the 300,000 people in Western PA that has diabetes. She's also a great example of how far treatment has come. She's lived with it for 43 years.
Many years ago, you would have to use a tube place drops of urine in it and throw a pill in there and watch it turn different colors.
Not something you could do at school. Now Terri has much more freedom. She tests her blood regularly and she wears an insulin pump.
This is what it looks like. You insert the spot yourself, and there's like a catheter that's inside in your body, and you change it every 3 or 4 days.
It's about the size of a beeper and dispenses insulin throughout the day.
I have the ability to be more flexible with my schedule in terms of eating, in terms of what I eat. If I eat more one day or I eat more at one meal, I will take insulin to cover it. If I eat less at a meal, I'll take less insulin to cover it.
I think the hardest part is it's really a marathon. You know, patients have it at every meal, every day.
There are about 26 million Americans who are in that marathon and 79 million who are about to be. They have pre-diabetes, on the brink of developing it, and most don't even know it. And that's tragic because there are things they could do to prevent it.
If people exercise 5 times a week, 30 minutes a day, and are able to drop their body weight 10%, their chances of going from pre-diabetes to diabetes is reduced by 58%.
Another thing people should do to prevent diabetes is eat a balanced diet. Encouraging prevention is important to all of us because it impacts you whether you know it or not.
Talk about the burden on the individuals as well as the direct family members, the health systems, the businesses. It is a tremendous burden on everybody.
Experts estimate the annual overall cost of diabetes in America is $174 billion. And listen to how hard it hits Western PA.
Right now, the latest statistics are $6.8 billion a year are spent in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania for people with diabetes.
So we are all paying for diabetes. Tomorrow night, a look at two surgeries that cure diabetes or at least put it in permanent remission. I'm going to tell you how you can qualify for those procedures. Also, this is really important. We are continuing to take action for you. Tomorrow night, we're bringing in a panel of experts from the West Penn Joslin Diabetes Center as well as the American Diabetes Association to answer your questions. So please call into our phone bank during our evening newscast with any questions you might have. And also tomorrow, I'm going to take you into a local research lab and show you how Pittsburgh is really on the cutting edge of finding a cure. Very exciting.
That is going to be something to tune in for. But think about tomorrow night. There's no reason not to sit, watch, call, ask questions, get involved.
Any questions about yourself, your children, your parents. Lots of experts here ready to answer your calls. So please call in.
Have that conversation.
Yeah,
it's very important.
Yeah.
Thanks, Michelle.